During our visit to the Kingfisher site in Chikube District near Lake Albert, as well as Tilenga in Bulisa, Peter Mulisa, the Chief Legal and Corporate Affairs Officer in UNOC, explained to us more about Uganda's oil project.
Target is 2025 to have Tilenga ready to produce the fluids, the crude oil, and to have them transported to Kabare Industrial Park, where the journey to Tanga for the crude oil commences, or to the refinery. Kingfisher, the land for the project is fully acquired. The rig for Kingfisher is in place. It has been set up. It's now erect and ready to proceed. So we should be able to launch the spudding in Kingfisher sometime towards the end of this month, or first week of Feb.
At Kingfisher, a 60.5-meter tall LR8001 rig is ready and drilling is expected to kick off by the first week of February. Meanwhile, another rig was set up by the China National Offshore Company at Tilenga in Bulisa District. Here, drilling is expected to start in March this year.
Behind us, you are able to see that we have our rig installed, and as you will see, the name of the rig is LR801 drilling rig that is able to drill up to 8,000 meters.
The Tilenga processing unit awaits a slab and assembly of equipment. It will process 190,000 barrels per year, whereas at Kingfisher, the ground is already leveled and earthworks for the central processing unit are ongoing. Kingfisher is expected to process 40,000 barrels per day. Overall, the two units of Tilenga and Kingfisher will process 230,000 barrels per day.
Now, what happens is that when crude oil is produced from the ground, it comes with a certain impurity. All the production from all the fields will be gathered and taken through the central processing facility. And once the crude is cleaned, that clean crude is what is sent to Kabare Industrial Park for export to the international market or for use in the refinery.
All the material required is available and being assembled to start drilling. Kingfisher is an offshore site, but accessed onshore, meaning the oil well is under the water table, while Tilenga, the well is directly underground onshore.
The onshore field in Tilenga, you'd have to drill directly in the ground, directly, and you don't have to deviate. The other one in Kingfisher, because it's offshore but accessed onshore, you have to drill it, you have to access it via land, but going under the lake, and you get to the reservoir, which is far below the lake basin.
Around, you'll see that the yard is now full. It's full. Yeah, we are ready. Once the inspection bay, that is the inspection bay under construction, once it is complete for us, we are really ready to start.
As a way to mitigate the dangers of climate change resulting from human activities like deforestation for charcoal and other energy supplies, the government is working on a policy that will see all Ugandans stop using firewood and charcoal. This comes in at a time when the country is set to produce its own gas. Mulisa advises Ugandans to be strategic and start earning from the oil project through bidding to supply and direct employment. He adds that Ugandans are given first priority in this project.
These products that we import, that we spend so much money on, will be produced here, and so that is import substitution. It supports our balance of trade, supports our balance of payment, it creates value chain employment, and so the factor of value that is created by just creating more products in terms of employment, in terms of taxes, in terms of know-how, supply chain, is what we're excited about, because that now brings in so many more Ugandans to participate.
The East African pipeline will be 1,443 kilometers long from Hoima to Tanga Port in Tanzania. It will be built with a capacity to transport 2,016 barrels of crude oil per day. Uganda's oil journey started when the country was still a British protectorate, with the first oil drilled in 1938 from the Rift Valley. When the World War hit, the activity stopped, and in the late 40s and 50s, the struggles for independence further delayed the project's progress. Later, in 1980, a law on petroleum was passed, but still nothing was done until 1997, when the current government decided to first train Ugandans in the oil sector. In 2011 and 2012, the first oil agreements were signed with different companies, and subsequently a bigger volume of 6.5 billion barrels of crude oil was confirmed underground. Since then, a lot of work has been done in terms of paperwork, land acquisition, skilling and certification. Hopefully, by 2025, Uganda will be able to produce her first oil. Story compiled by Rogers Akanyinjuka and Ivan Senyonjo for the news.